Welcome back, everybody, to Maplestory. So, last episode I left off with a little cliffhanger of this mysterious letter of warning, which I'm going to read right now. Jett clone, take a look at this creepy letter I got. It says, on 7/12, oh, this is for Phantom. Oh, wow, that's a little lame. On 7/12/12, I'll steal the heart of your dead friend, Jett clone. I actually read online, this is supposed to say dear friend Jett clone, and it says dead friend Jett clone, which I think actually dead friend Jett clone, that sounds a little better. I will steal the heart of your dead friend. That sounds a little better than dear friend, but it is supposed to be dear friend. And then it's Phantom. It's just, you know, it's promoting Phantom class, which sounds like it's, and the Phantom class is getting a lot more promotion, I think, than Jett did. Let's see, this sounds weird. Maybe this guy will show himself. do you think he'll be handsome? Oh, Cassandra. Okay. Oh yeah, he sent me something. He sends you an envelope, and I think you open this and you get like a item. Oh no, okay, you get a little buff, and yeah, an item, right? Yeah. Okay, here we go. So you get this item, which you can equip to your Phantom whenever you want to. What is it? It's a card. Oh yeah, because the Phantom is like, you know, he uses playing cards. The best thing I can probably put my finger on Phantom is if you guys ever watch X-Men. The character Gambit, it's a spitting image of Gambit. I think they really took a lot of Gambit stuff, because Gambit used playing cards, and he used canes, and he used magic, and it's just, they totally took Gambit's idea, I think. But I don't know, that's just me. Alright, so here we go. Now we can get our blue ribbon pig out, because we're level 13, and we can continue on with the quests. Oh, what is this? Wait, one-stop event info. Events of Maplestory, yep. Oh, yeah, there's an event menu now. And you can check it. Oh, yeah, here it is. Pink Zakum, which is actually a pretty cool quest. I've done that twice, I think. You fight, like, a fake Zakum, which is this huge rock monster, and you get the chance of getting one of these two really nice items. I don't know what the rest of these are. You can get a ring? Really? How do you get a ring? Oh, I don't know. All right, anyway, yeah, let's continue on. Pork delivery number 2! Alright. Should ask Tanguyun about a dish. He's the chef. Let's see. Take this bag of pork to the cafeteria on the Nautilus. Alright. He's in the cafeteria. Sounds good to me. Let's go there. I love the little mini arrows that help you out with, like, the first few quests. It's nice. I also love the music. The Maplestory music is kind of like the Pokemon themes, where, like, once you listen to them once, as soon as you just kind of listen, like, you start to listen to it again, you can immediately pick up on it and start, like, singing along with it. I don't think anybody's ever, like, played a Pokemon game can deny that they can't just sing along with, like, the Pokemon Center music, because you just heard it a million times. Alright, anyway, cafeteria. Ooh, a Gachapon's in here, I did not know that. Gachapon is kind of like the lottery in Maple. You buy them with real money. But I'm not going to do that. Okay. Pork delivery. Will you show up now? I contacted cereal ages ago. Fine, whatever. Let's see the food. You fatty. Good old ribbon pig brings a tear to my eye. Okay. Is that a panda? Yes, it is. It's like Po from Kung Fu Panda, who's a chef. Okay, let's see. All right. Let's see. Are you ready to see the ultimate unbeatable pork dish? Oh, that almost leveled me up. That's a bummer. The best seasoning. Quality pork like this needs the very best seasoning. Okay, yeah. I thought so. Why don't you give me some? Sure. Go to Pig Pasture and get me one herb leaf. I have to harvest plants there. Where's Pig's Pasture? Alright, so that's to the left. That's to the left of Nautilus. Fine. They don't take too long unless you want to eat rancid pork. Oh, I love rancid pork. Hey, I can't believe we're actually talking about that in front of my blue ribbon pig. You must be, like, mortified. Alright. Let's go and pick an herb. You know, guys, come on, it's the early quests. It's, like, lame, go pick an herb, go kill a pig. I mean, like, what else do you really expect? You know, later on, we're gonna be, like, saving the world from the Black Mage and all that different junk. Here we go. Give me an herb. Yay! Done! Well, that was actually easy. Let me level up before I go back. There we go. Yeah, you get him, Blue Ribbon Pig. Okay. Boom. And I still haven't looked up a skill tree guide, but I'm just going to go with my gut. I'm going to do everything that's important. I'm going to do the important stuff, which is not the... It's everything that's not an attack, normally is the important stuff, because in MapleStory, a lot of your attacks always are overwritten in the next job, so usually applying skill points to all of your attacking skills is not as beneficial as applying them to your passive skills, because, yeah, they just get overran, like, later on in game. So I'm going to make sure I max out all of my passive skills, and then I'll start working on my, active skills. How do I get over there? Come on. I jumped too high. There we go. All right, let's give this back. The only thing I still have found wrong with Maple with the arrows is that after you complete the quest, it doesn't tell you how to get back. It just still tells you how to get there. But, oh well. I have a lot of the maps memorized anyway. All right, best seasoning done. All right, that's a little kind of low XP, but sure. I better get to cooking. Yep. All right. Feast of Dairy Dough. Can you give me a hand? I forgot to feed the cows. The pirate cows, that is. Let's see, baby cows get hungry real fast. If I don't get some food in the bellies, they'll probably stampede. All right. Wait, what? I have to regular attack the hay to the cows. All right, that makes sense. And then bring a cup of milk from the mama cow. Wait, get a cup of milk from the mama cow after you feed the baby cows. All right, I think this is one of those kind of tutorials about how you can break items in the game, which is just holding your normal attack like this. And you just kind of give it a little pause and you can just keep breaking these. And it's lame. And in the original MapleStory, this used to be breaking boxes to get like nuts and like screws to like make a chair or something. And it was just the lamest thing ever. And it still is. I thought that didn't drop it. All right, wait, so that's the mama cow, because you can see the obvious lipstick. And these are the three baby cows, but there's only two troughs. So I'm wondering if I drop just... Oh, how do I do this then? Oh, I just click on them. Okay. All right, so I need just two, right? Oh, no, that's mama cow too. Wait, what? Oh, I have to give... Okay, so there's two baby cows, there's two mama cows. That sounds good. And that... Okay, they took all of that. Let's get the cup of milk. Yay, cup of milk. Sweet. All right, very easy quest. Let's go back and tell him. There we go. Hey, how's it going? How's it going? Okay, you leave. Fine. All right. Let's see. We got a half glove. Sweet. For level 15. I cannot wear that. Almost there. That's just some basic equipment right there. I'm going to probably end up getting that glove from the equipment boxes that are going around right now. Because the Jett, they give all the equipment boxes out, like every level. Like every five levels. A bite for Bane. Alright, let's see. Bane skipped the meal. Alright, why don't you bring Bane his lunch? Okay, as long as Bane's not a hungry dog, I'll give him his lunch. Where's Bane? Alt jump down. Even though my jump's not even on Alt. It's on X. X. Eeks. Alright, where's Bane? Bane! Mommy brought your lunch. Come here. Ooh, poke that shark. You poke that shark. All right, here he is. Bite for Bane. Yep. Here's your lunch. God, I feel like so lame. Come on, I'm like a legendary space pirate, and I'm giving this guy his lunch? Oh, boy. All right, those obnoxious starfish. Ugh, they're so loud. Okay. Listening to the sea. I can't hear dang thing over the starfish. How much noise can starfish make? Really now? All right, so they are on the fourth. Yeah, it's the fourth map out. Level 17, I just actually saw. That's kind of high. All right, take out 30 yellow starfish. That'll be easy. Let's go do that. So pretty much like what the starting quests do is they kind of just take you throughout all of the maps of your starting city. So I'm pretty sure the end quest will probably have a quest right here. On the Florina beach, or possibly out here, like somewhere, you know, on the way to the beach, something like this. It normally brings you through all of these maps with quests to kind of boost your XP, just to, you know, I don't know, that's what I noticed. So, you know, we're working our way out right now, and we're on the fourth map out of how many? Let's see, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8... 9, 10, 11, 12. I didn't count the blue because that's just the Florina Beach. So there's like 12. I'm guessing it'll probably go through all of those. We're going to probably have to hit... Or we're going to have to probably go to Florina Beach at some time, which is a kind of like... It used to be a separate area, but I'm guessing now they just kind of fused it together with with this place, with Nautilus. It wasn't always like that. Okay, anyway. Let's go to this portal. Can I get up here? Really? No? Oh, there we go. You have to, like, do a weird jump out of there. Okay. Hello, piggies! I need a mob skill. The only mob skill I have is that uppercut, and I'm still kind of wary on even using it, or even upgrading it, because it might be completely useless. Okay. Actually, you know what? Let's do that right now. So, if I get 3 skill points, and I have 16 more levels, that means I have 48 skill points. So, 48 skill points will max out Glide Blast, and leave me 40 left. It'll max out Double Shot, and it'll leave me, what, 11? No. Yes. 19? No, 21. Wait, I need to recount. 19, 40 minus 19 is 21. Okay, yeah. And then 21 will let me get Comet Booster up to 10, and then Tornado Upcut up to 11. So, as long as I don't boost Tornado Upcut up to 11, I won't be messing up my skills. And that is how you do it, ladies and gentlemen. That is how you learn how to distribute your skill points. Yeah, so Tornado Upcut can go up to 11, and then I have to stop. That sounds reasonable. Because Tornado Uppercut is my only mob move right now where I can hit more than one enemy. Wow, little starfish. These guys sure are making a lot of noise. Can't you hear them, Blue Ribbon Pig? Look at how much noise they're making as I kill them and slaughter their entire family and race. Yay, leveled up. Die. Man, I shoot fast. I got a mage hat just then as a drop, which is kind of useless to me. But speaking of equipment, I'm pretty sure I can get... Yay, another box. Hooray. Let's use that real quickly. Boom. Yay, more equipment. Yeah, and I got the copy of the gloves that I had before. All right, let's see. I'm going to skip the hat. Why do I not have 15 strength? Oh, I didn't apply my AP. That's why. So yeah, the auto-assign will give you as much strength and dex as you need to equip your items, you know, limits, or not limits, requirements. So this needs 15 strength, the auto sign will give you 1 strength each level, that's pretty much how it goes. Alright, let's do a Tornado Uppercut, just because I haven't seen that yet, and then let's continue on doing Glide Blast. I don't know, I'm just kind of throwing them around. Once again, it's the first job, it doesn't really matter. Okay, so yeah, so D is mommy, is normally my mob skill, and then S is my single skill, single hitter, I don't know what to really call that. Okay, here we go. We got some other stuff, too. No, those are knuckles. I don't need knuckles. I need a gun. There we go. Oh, but my gun is so much cooler. Oh, but this does a lot more damage. No, but this is fast. Hmm. I wonder which is better. Normal 18 or fast 13? Whatever. I'll use a new gun. But that gun shot so quickly. Oh. Alright, hold on, let me really quickly put this mana elixir to my control. And then, oh, I forgot I even had a chair. Let's put that to shift just for the heck of it. Alright, let's see what double uppercut, or not double uppercut, that's a different, tornado uppercut, let's see what that does. I want to get a good mob, but the blue ribbon pig is killing all of them. Alright, here we go. Ooh, that's actually really nice. Ooh, so it actually extends like a whirlwind at them. That is pretty sick. Alright, so let's see how this does well. Oh, nice. There we go. Now we can kill huge hordes of monsters very quickly. Alright, that's already done. Oh, one thing I forgot to buy from the merchant was Return to Town Scrolls. And I'm about to die. Hold on. Whoa. I forgot to buy Return to Town Scrolls. Those would help a lot. They return you right to town without having to walk. You just double-click the mouse, and boom, you're done. Ooh, I like the uppercut. But yeah, I heard it gets replaced by another mob skill very early into a second job, so I'm just going to leave it for now. You know, at a low level. Alright, let's go back. Ooh, the episode's almost over. Man, these maple, like, flies by. It's a total, like, time sucker. I'll play for a little longer than I did last episode this time. Just because, ooh, a cannon. Oh, I can't pick it up. Just because I feel like it. I don't feel like getting off this early. We haven't really done much. We did, like, what, a few quests? 4 quests or something? Alright, let's go tell this guy that I quieted down the stupid starfish. Ooh, what title did I get? Oh, I got Beginner Adventurer. Alright, yay! So, another thing in the game, which I think is also amazing, is the medal system. The medal system is pretty sweet because, like, throughout all your jobs, if you get to, like, level 10, 30, 70, 120, you'll get a medal, like I just got right here, which has its own little slot in your equipment area to equip to, and then you know, they have general ones like this, explore like main regions, have 50 characters at level 50, stuff like that. And then you can have like, there's some of these weirder ones, like all of these that are kind of just for oddball achievements. Then there's the challenges, which are kind of cool. A little bit, a lot harder, like this one, 100,000 monsters. That's like impossible for me. I don't know, I can't do that. And then you also get some medals for doing some dungeons, like some like theme dungeons, which are pretty cool. And yeah, the medals are amazing, are an amazing system. Because also, once you equip your medal, what happens is under your name, you actually get the medal saying it, you know, says it right there, which is really cool. So yeah, that's a whole cool system they have there going there too. The medals and the Crusader Codex are definitely some of the best updates. Well, even though Crusader Codex is pretty old, but and so are the medals. But I don't know. I when I say new and like updates, I'm talking from a very, you know, old time, an old time when, you know, MapleStory was just a C program and, you know, no one was level 10 now. But all right, here we go. All right, starfish. Yay! There's a big old shockwave heading our way. Okay, that's not good, actually. Yay, leveled up again. Sweet. So yeah, I'm pretty sure these quests will take me until level 30. They should, at least. I mean, that usually happens. If you do them all, it should take you to level 30. Okay. And let's, I don't know, what? What do you, now I'll just put some comp boost. Why not? And then just throw some more in a glide blast. Now I'm just going even faster. Alright, another quest. Whose job is it anyway? Like, whose line is it anyway? I love that show. If only Bart weren't slacking off, I would have had this problem. Bart, is he supposed to keep the starfish in check? Oh, that Bart. Alright, go knock some sense in him. Probably lousing around at Nautilus Harbor, which is just outside, okay? It's his fault you had to fight all them starfish. Yeah, because they were real tough. Those starfish. Okay. Yeah, you hang in there, Bonnie. Hang in there. Nope, nobody can help you. Okay, how do I get up here? Wee. Nope, wrong entrance. Sorry. Ooh, I don't want to talk to that thing. That talking water cooler. Alright, here we go. Whoosh. 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 Okay. Let's see. What do we got out here? Alright, where is he? See, these arrows also stop, I'm pretty sure, once you get second job, I want to say. Once you get second job, I think the arrows stop. Alright, here we go. Where am I going? Bart! Damn starfish! Dude, damn starfish. Okay. Who are you? I ain't slacking off. Blah, blah, hat. Alright, yeah, I'm supposed to keep the starfish monsters in line when something came up. I asked Coleco, like a ColecoVision gaming system, to take over for me. Blame him, not me. Let me go guess. I have to go talk to Coleco. Yep, nap time for Coleco. What's he doing anyway? Go bug him about this. He probably fell asleep at the White Wave Harbor. Alright, so that's four out. So that's where the starfish are. Oops, I just quit out of the quest. Oh well. Alright, back to there. Huzzah! Whee. Oops. No. Jump, and then there we go. The double jumping is kind of, you know, iffy. Like, the swimming is kind of iffy with Jett because of his double jump ability. Alright, now let's go give this guy a piece of our mind. Let me X that out. Making us kill all those starfish. I'm going to use haste just to kind of speed this up a little bit. Oh, I forgot to buy the stupid Return to Town scrolls again. Oh, should I do it? Yeah, I guess. No. Oh, God. I don't know. I'll go. I have to, like, splash the cold water on his face or something. I'll go do that, and then I'll just off-camera go to town and get some town scrolls for next episode, because I'm about to finish. All right, let's go give this guy a piece of our mind. Is that what I'm supposed to splash it? I don't know. It doesn't actually say. Die! Fear my mob skill. All right, where is this punk, this rascal? Hey, there you are. Let's do this. This is a steak, so yummy. Ooh, I got a slipper, which I already have because of the events. What was that for? I'm guessing I did splash it on him. Let's see, Bart asked me to watch the monsters, but I forgot. You dunce. What cannot be? Oh, I can't actually use my whirlwind attack if I'm not next to monsters? Oh, that's weird. Normally they'll let you just do your skills wherever you want, but I actually can't use the whirlwind unless there's a monster. Did you see? Look at that range! The hell? What kind of range is that? How can I hit monsters way up there from way down? That's insane. Wow. That is an insane amount of range right there. Okay, anyway. Wow. Just a catnap. Yeah, okay. Yeah, you get him, Blue Ribbon Pig. I don't want to be in trouble. Bart will throw me in the ocean if he hears that I fell asleep on the job. Okay, yeah. Can you get rid of, like, 50 yellow starfishes? He just turned into a dude, a bro. Let's see. Okay, yeah. 50 yellow... Oh, I just to hunt more? That's lame. Lame. Even though this probably won't go that slowly. Still lame. I can just kill these guys. I'll have a whole map just in under my control with this freaking skill. Alright, so, yeah, that concludes episode 3, everybody. Yay, leveled up. Let me do this. That includes episode 3. We're level 17. It's not bad. Almost in the 20s. Starting to get up there. Let's do more tornado uppercut for now. Because I can get that at least to like 10 or 11 without having to worry. So yeah, we pretty much just kind of helped around the ship this episode. We didn't really do much other than that. And we beat some starfish. But yeah, all right. So I'm kind of debating right now whether or not I think I might just kill these starfish on camera really quickly and then throw it over to next episode, which is going to be amazing because there's going to be an explosion or something. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoy the consistency I'm trying to make these videos. I know the first episode had a very long pause until like the second one, but yeah, and also hopefully you guys like the resolution too. Hopefully that's a little more bearable. Alright, oop, completed. Alright, cool. So I'm going to go talk to him about that and scold him for not killing monsters next episode. But until then, I hope you guys all enjoyed, and I will see you guys all later.